Hello friends, welcome back. Myself Sanjay Kumar Adhikari, and welcome to new members. So this block is in continuation of my last block. I have discussed this block at this particular YouTube channel. So as you know that various C implementations such as NCC, C95 and C99 we discussed in the last block. Similarly, there are various Python implementations are also there. So what are those? C Python, written in C, and this is the original Python, and Jython, written in Java, and PyPy, written completely in Python and support some advanced features such as stackless support, you know, JIT compiler, just-in-time compiler, Iron Python, written in Python for the .NET applications. So first of all, let's see which particular Python is stored in our setup, my setup in this particular case. So for that, what we need to do, if we simply start Python here, then import platform, and this command we have to write, a platform dot Python implementation. Okay, so C Python, this will come. So anyway, this is given here also. So in my particular case, is it is the C Python. So depending on that case to case basis, that whatever you have installed. So another question come, where is the Python installation folder, so that we can look into that particular folder. Similarly, you can import sys and this particular command, you can sys.executable. In my case, this particular path comes, and if I go to that particular path, okay, so I look into this Python file, and within the Python, this is the Python folder complete. Okay, within the Python, documentation folder is also there. If you double click on that, then you will see that documentation related to the Python, lot of stuff related to the Python tutorial, and lot of stuff is available there. Okay, so that is the detail is there. And that is that official detail, so you can refer to that. And anyway, if you in the command line, if you use echo and this particular command, so you will find the complete path. Within that also, you will find this particular Python. That's why it is executing here. Okay, so let's continue our comparison with C. So other questions, last time we, you know, understood just how to start it as in a calculator style, some commands. So similarly, if we write some commands, so there may be some commands will be required. What happens in C? Suppose if you are writing statement by statement, single line. So in C, normally we use this double slash, or if it is a block, then we use slash star, but for single we use this. In Python we use this slash, and then each line in C requires a well-defined statement followed by termination. You have to have this semicolon in the C statement, unless you are not using some other control statement like if or any other things, you know, for loop, all those kind of things. Otherwise, as normal statement, you need this kind of termination. So in Python, we can have any assignment, expression, function, method, without any termination symbol. So we can simply write 1 plus 2. So I think we already tried that last time. Simply if you write, let's say 1 plus 2. Okay, so it will like execute. It will provide that output, something like that, similar to calculator. And in C, we use this, you know, backslash to extend macro definition to multiple lines. So if we define macro, you know, macro as basically you can think of some text which will be replaced in the pre-process state in the code. So let's say test is here. So line one statement is there, line two is there. So that will be separated by this. So if your statement, you know, you want to put multiple line statement in a particular macro, so that option is this in C. And normally you may find this any header file of C and all that, where the macro functions are being used. Okay, in Python we use the same thing but for statement purpose. Here what we do, multiple physical lines can be to a single logical statement or logical line. What is the physical line? Physical line means properly terminated carriage return line feed when you enter, correct? So carriage return line feed terminology from the typewriter basically. So when you return and line feed, so in our case it is like enter or these you know symbols passed in some other systems depending on that, these kind of termination symbols. So that's why I, for simple understanding purpose, like simply enter. So what can happen, multiple lines, we can make one logical line, means one logical means one complete statement. Let's say this is the example. If roll number is greater than 1 and roll number less than 20, there may be another statement. There we will see that other logical statement for covering this, but for the timing, just for explanation purpose, I am showing this. So then backslash, then and marks, then backslash, and this colon we will discuss below, that because the next is you know after if, that indent has to be used, so that's why the colon is there, that I will discuss below. Then print this. So this whole is a single statement now, single logical statement. If this condition fulfills, basically these two and then this one, print this, something like that. So if you are using parenthesis, square, curly braces, you know, brackets, and then definitely you don't need this backslash. That is different thing. And in C++, so this is for multiple statements, kind of for this particular multiple line, physical line, one logical statement for Python. And now let's come to combining many statement, multiple statement to one particular block. So in C we use this, you know, braces and to define a block of code or grouping the statement. Python uses leading white space or tab, one tab equal to 4 spaces in the logical line to start the indentation and end with the empty logical line. What do you mean? Let's try to understand this, what I mean here. And then suppose this is one statement, count equal to 10, and right now this is just for understanding purpose, so this is not a particular program, but just to understand the program, count equal to 10 I have written because I have to initialize the count variable. There is no other way to initialize the count variable in Python. You know that we cannot say int count kind of stuff. We have to assign some value. So in later we may use some other command like input count and provide the count from the keypad, but for the time being I am just putting it count equal to 10. So second, let's say you are going to use this particular command. So if count is greater than 100, then print count. And ideally, what should happen here, like there should be, there is a issue here that there will be 4 white spaces here actually before the print. Okay. So then otherwise it will throw the error. Then only next you can see 3 dot here for indentation. So next I have just entered so that I can use the another command. Okay. So basically these kind of things, if you use in a text file, then it is good. Because this interactive mode is mainly for testing certain expression, it's fine. But if you are doing these kind of things, it is always better to use that. Or other way, like I will try to explain you using that IPython. That what I mean, that white spaces. Let's try IPython is another version of this Python that let me try to quit. In that is just utility inside this Python. I will not say another version. Let me correct it. IPython. If I use IPython, okay. Now you can say here the same thing. I will use count equal to, let's say, 10. And second, let me see if I can. I cannot magnify it anyway. And then if count is greater than 100, then I have to put this particular colon here so that I will show you that this one. I am not sure whether you are able to see it, but let me try again. Then you can see this 3, your dot dot dot, this left side, and next here automatically you can see the different distance from this to this around 4 spaces automatically it has taken. So if I type directly print count and enter, fine. Then I don't want another statement within this if command. So what I can do, I can again, I don't want to make a block here now, enter again. So next statement will come, then I can simply type my next command, print count, and because the first statement anyway was not true, so that though no result was there, so print count will give that result. And so this is what we call it IPython. So IPython, I hope you understood that what is that indentation means here. And normally, in let's say I will show you here, and let's say in Notepad. And see what you do normally. Suppose if you do if, and if you write some statement, let's say if I is greater than 100. So normally you start a statement somewhere here, correct? Print. So this kind of thing you use. Or sometime if you are using a block, then basically use the braces. You use that braces and then you write the particular command. So this is the way you use in C. And in I have not completed that, so don't take it otherwise, like print up or whatever command further. And you need line termination also. And within print up, you suppose if you want to print just I, then print this, okay, something like that. So that is C. So in here the method is indentation is that, like that we have to give a gap here actually. four spaces at this. So this is the wrong right now. So it should be, there should be four spaces in here. So as I have explained in IPython. So interactive Python can be used for quick testing of some expression, but whatever command you enter will be lost after experiment. So you need to use a text editor such as Notepad, VI to create a .py file similar to .c. Okay. For example, how you will execute this Python test.py to execute the test.py file. I will show you again that I have one file here. I will show you in the directory, and in the directory we have the test.py, and if I cat this test.py here, so this is simple print hi count, this is simple command, and let's say Python test.py. So first hi printed, then count 5, then it is doing count count plus 1, so count will be here anyway 6, then it is printing 6. So here you can see clearly indent also, you see 4 spaces, that's why there is no error here. And also in between count was less than 100, count initially 5, but anyway that print command was not there, so that's why no print was there. So anyway, this is doing this. So suppose if you want to continue, right now it has terminated, so if you want to continue this, so what we can use I option to analyze. Let's say if I do this option and same test.py, what will happen? It has stopped there. Now you can analyze here again. Let's say you can analyze any variable here, print count, you can again analyze what is the count, because it has not terminated yet. So count is already there, so 6. Anyway, you can if there is another variable, you can add and try that also. So that is the way that when you combine many Python statements and make a particular function and put that in a file, so then it makes sense for this. Okay, so in C, you know that right now whatever we are discussing, that is related to whatever we write our application. But at the same time, what is the benefit of using Python is that to utilize its rich library. And similarly, what is the benefit of using C that utilize its rich library, apart from that whatever that compiler related things we are using converting to that machine code in case of C. So C, for example, if you use this printf command first time, so you use simply stdio.h, so you don't have to write yourself printf command, you know, printf function. So in C++ you use simply include add stdio.h, and C++ maybe another command conio dot or whatever. C you use this stdio.h, and then in Python import statement is used to access modules if it is not part of the built-in, because you have seen that I was using print command straight forward without any include any import. So print command is the built-in. If it is not there, then you have to import the module. Okay, and modules, we know what modules are available. If you go to the help and list the modules, click, you know, run the module command. Last time I think we have seen that. But what about the built-in? What built-in functions are available? How to find out that? Import built-in and directory built-in. So this is the input, Nico, and this is the output, orange color. Complete. So here we can find, let's say I have just I have some only few here. Ideally Basically, there are many actually. If we quickly go to this import and let's say built-in and directory within that built-in, you can see built-in is a modules built-in, and within the module we have many functions, so those functions we can see. So this is the list. So I wanted to focus mainly on print one, where it is not visible here, or should be, yeah, this one, sorry, it is already highlighted, the print command. So that's why we don't import any module for built-in, because it is a built-in function. Okay, so let's say example of what we then import. Let's say example of math module. Okay, let's see how it works. Import math, and within the math there are functions, factorial, math dot factorial, math dot, so two we I have used factorial, square root. So again, how to find out which functions are available within that directory math? Fine. So similar way, if you use here import math and simply see directory math and what all folders or that functions are available within the math module. So you can see POW, power function, radian, sine, you know, square root, tan, those kind of functions are available here. Okay, so by the way, how Python finds its modules? Like you can understand built-in is already there within the, you know, Python itself, within the wherever the Python is executing. But how are the modules, any other module, custom modules? So that basically there is a provision of Python path environment variable also. Otherwise you can always find that using again import sys, system related thing, and sys.path, that will give you the path what it used for searching. Let's say import sys and sys.path. So you will find the these are the paths actually. It should look for that. Mainly library path should be there. Okay. For the module. So that is the one thing, and references I have provided, and directory I have shown you that directory inside that. You can go to the documentation and lot of like some of that detailed I might have skipped. For example, I am not explaining in the detail how that particular curly bracket or any parenthesis you have to use, and how that particular syntax example, lot of things I have not discussed. I am just highlighting the main thing. So other things like lot of detail you will find here, and some tutorial in that web also, lot of those things are when you start using this. First let's to try to understand what all the features, what are the main highlights of this particular language. Okay, so and please subscribe to YouTube channel if you have not done yet, and just click on this link, and right now you are watching this, so you can just after end of this, on the left side that Embed Kari icon will appear, you just click on that and then subscribe. And if you are interested in open source tools and technology, check that open source discovery platform at this particular link. Okay, thanks for your time.